The atomic radius is a periodic property. Though not a rigorously defined quantity, as atoms do not have clearly defined boundaries, we can estimate atomic radii by looking at internuclear distances in various molecules. Going down in a column or group, the atomic radius increases. This is to be expected, as going down in a group means occupying an atomic orbital with a greater principal quantum number. Going from left to right in a row or period, the radius decreases. This may be counterintuitive, as more electrons might require more space. However, the radius decreases since the effective nuclear charge increases as we go from left to right. The increased effective charge pulls the valence electrons closer to the nucleus, and the atom gets smaller. Remember that ions can be very different from their parent atoms. When an atom becomes an anion, the radius increases since the effective charge remains the same, but additional valence electrons means greater repulsion, making the anion more diffuse. When an atom loses electrons to become a cation, it becomes smaller. It can become very much smaller if the atom's valence is emptied and the cation has a new valence, one principal quantum number lower. For example, sodium is a relatively big atom with a valence of n equals 3, but the loss of an electron produces a much smaller cation with a valence of n equals 2. With one more proton in the nucleus, the sodium cation even becomes smaller than the neon atom with whom it shares the same electronic configuration. Another periodic property is the ionization energy, the energy required to remove an electron. As we go down a group, the ionization energy decreases. The effective charge remains the same, but the valence electrons are further away from the nucleus and more easily removed. As we go from left to right in a period, the ionization energy tends to increase as the effective charge increases and the electron is more tightly pulled towards the nucleus. However, there are two exceptions as we go from left to right in each period. It is actually easier to ionize a group 3 atom than a group 2 atom. This is because the group 3 atom has a p electron that is higher in energy and thus more easily removed. We also have an exception between group 5 and group 6. This is because the p orbitals in the group 5 atom have a single electron in each and all share the same spin. In group 6, one of the p orbitals is doubly occupied and the electron of opposite spin is destabilized by the other electron in its orbital, making it easier to remove. As with the radius, be sure not to confuse atoms with ions. The sodium atom is much larger and easier to ionize than the neon atom. However, the sodium cation is actually smaller and harder to ionize than the neon atom, as both have the same electronic configuration, but the sodium cation has one extra proton in its nucleus. Finally, we have two other general features in groups. If we were ever asked which element within a group is the most different from the others, it's typically the first atom. This is due to its much smaller size, and being in the second period limits its chemistry to s and p electrons. D orbitals become a factor once we enter the third period, and the principal quantum number equals 3. Also, if asked which element from another group most resembles an element, it is the one to the right and one column down. We call this the diagonal effect, and it arises from the fact that these atoms tend to have similar charge-to-radius ratios.